In today's video, we're going to look at how we can edit the Control Center on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Apple completely changed how this all works with iPadOS 18. Now, before we get started, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can now edit the Control Center on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. Now, in past versions of iPadOS, the way that we customized our Control Center was through the Settings app. Let's go ahead and tap on that. And then what we need to do is we need to go over to Control, or I should say we needed to go over to our Control Center. And when we tap on Control Center here, what we have here is an option to allow us to access the Control Center from within apps. And then below that, if you're using an older version of iPadOS, what you're able to do in this area here was add and remove controls. That's basically how we customized them. Well, as you can see, we have a big blank area here. The only option we have is access within apps. So let's first cover what this is, and then we'll go and see how we can actually edit the Control Center through the Control Center. That's how we do it with iPadOS 18. So this access within apps, what is this? Well, basically what this allows us to do is access the Control Center when we're within an app. So I have this on right now, which means I'm in the Settings app. If I swipe down from the upper right-hand corner, what it's going to do, this is how I access my Control Center. When I swipe down, I get my Control Center. That's basically all this is allowing us to do. I'm not on the home screen. I am accessing it from within another app. If I turn this off, and now I swipe down from the upper right-hand corner, you're going to see that it brings me to my Notification Center. I cannot access the Control Center unless I am on the home screen. So now I'm going to swipe up, and now when I swipe down from the upper right-hand corner, I can get to the Control Center. So the only way that I can access this is from the home screen. Now I'm going to turn this back on. I actually like to have it accessible from within any app. So I'm just going to tap on that to turn it on. So that's the only setting that we have from within this Control Center settings. So now, how do we edit our Control Center? What's the new way of doing that on iPadOS 18? Well, what we need to do is we just need to go and access the Control Center. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to swipe down from the upper right-hand corner. We need to access our Control Center. I swipe down. I'm looking at my Control Center. Now what I'd like to do is I would like to edit. I would like to add more controls, and we can add a lot more controls. I can even resize these controls. So how do we do that? Well, we have to go into the edit mode. Two different ways to do that. I can tap on the little plus here. You're going to see there's a little plus there. Or what I can do is I can just tap and hold in this area here, just like we're on the home screen, but we're in the Control Center. When I tap and hold, it goes into the edit mode. It does the same thing when I tap on that little plus. So now what does all this mean? You're going to see that I have little arcs here. I can remove a control, and you're going to see that there's a little grid here. What does all this mean? Well, basically what we're able to do is resize these just by dragging this little arc in the lower right-hand corner of each control. I can move them around. So if I wanted to move this battery control down to here, all I have to do is just drag it. Go back into edit mode. It turned off accidentally. I waited too long there. But basically, all I have to do is just drag this down. And now I can place that control down there. Let's go ahead and resize it. This is the battery control. I want to have this a little larger. So I'm just going to bring it up here. And now I just take this and drag it. So I take that little arc and I drag it. I'm doing this with my left hand here, so it's a little bit tricky. Let's try it again here. There we go. And we have our low power mode. So I can easily resize that, especially if I was using my right hand instead of my left hand. If I wanted to make it back to the regular size, I can just drag it. And now it's back to its regular size. And I can place it back up here where I want. So we can resize and easily move our controls. Now, we can't do this to every control. You're going to see that I cannot resize these controls here, the little sliders. So not every control is going to be resizable, but we can easily move them. If you want to remove it, you just tap on the little minus here and it'll remove that control. What about adding controls? So I know how to remove them. I know how to move them. I know how to resize them. What about adding new controls? To do that, what we do is we tap on add new control. Let's go back into my edit mode here. Again, I took too long, so I long press on it. Pretty simple to do. And now I tap on add a control. When I do that, I'm going to have a list of all of the different controls that I can add, including third-party controls. So developers can add their own controls in here. And all I have to do is just swipe up to find the control I want. Or what I can do is I can search controls. Once I find the control, let's go ahead and add the alarm here. Once I find the control, I just tap on it. And we can see that it added that control. And then I can go and move it around if I want. I can also resize it. So again, we just tap on add control, find our control. Then we just go and tap on it to add it. Then what we do is we go and place it where we want. Now, the last thing I want to show you is different pages. You're also going to notice, you may have noticed, that when we look over here on the right, we have different pages. So I have the heart. Those are my favorite controls. So this is where I would place my controls that I want to have easy access to. But below that, we are going to see that I have a little musical note icon. Well, when I swipe up, that's my music control. And below that, we have another control. And this is where I can turn on my airplane mode, my AirDrop, VPN if I had one. And if I swipe up again, you're going to see that I have one more page here. When I swipe up, this is a blank slate. So now what I'm able to do is place all kinds of controls in here. So I could get really control heavy if I wanted to. Just tap on add a control, add it there, drag it where I want, and resize it. So in addition to placing our controls anywhere we want, we also have additional pages here. Now, one thing you can't do as of this recording is we cannot reorder these pages. So if you wanted to move music down towards the bottom, at least as far as I can tell, we cannot do that yet. Maybe that'll be something that'll be coming forth in an update, but we cannot move those pages around. So that's how we now edit our control center on the iPad with iPadOS 18. It basically works the same way on the iPhone with iOS 18. I would recommend playing around with this a little bit. I will admit I was a little overwhelmed when I first started playing around with it. I'm like, there's a lot of controls in here. But once I got used to it, when you go into the control center and you want to edit it and add a control, you're going to find, or you will possibly find, that there's going to be more controls that are available to you, especially as third-party developers start embracing this. So you may find that it may be a little bit easier to control your iPad just by playing around with some of these controls. So that is how we now edit our control center on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, you can click on the bell, you get notifications when I release a new video. But in addition to that, what you may want to do is check out my site, danstutorials.com. I've been doing YouTube for a few years now, and I have over 400 videos on there. But on my site, which I've been doing over a decade, I have over 2,100 videos, all on how to use your Apple devices and Apple software. And the way that you can help support my efforts is by becoming a member of my site. When you become a member of my site, all of the videos are ad-free, so you're not going to see any ads. You also get access to my online webinars and classes that I hold on a regular basis. I created an AI assistant based on an Apple Genius. So then if you have a question, you can go right into the AI assistant. And in a lot of cases, I would dare say most cases, it'll probably be able to help you. And then the last thing is, when you do become a member, you are helping support a small business. It's just me sitting in a corner office of my house here, and I enjoy creating these videos. So just know that when you do become a member, you are helping support my efforts in creating these videos, and you're supporting a small business. So if you want to learn more, check out danstutorials.com. I hope this video is helpful in your quest to make your iPad more productive.